all changed when the daughter was born. Wow. The reward for the most cliche line goes to me. So, I'm here. For a place belonging to a posh-ass agency, this is weird. If they wanted to have a decor that corresponds with story, they succeeded. It's dark, there are rats, and it's weird paintings. Not gonna lie, I felt like it was some fucked up experiment, especially since the man called to check if I'm working soon after I entered. I heard a strange noise when I was about to start writing, but it turned out that it were only rats, I think. I thought I saw later. I called to let him know I'm here. He always cheers me up.
Don't ride city buses. This is your chance to end segregation.
Children change every... Reach for your own experience. I know what it is to be a parent. What changes with a child? Channel it!
We had an agreement, a deadline, that you prolonged for the third time now. If you don't finish this screenplay, someone else will.
It's me.
Mama? Did something happen?
I don't know. I don't feel good. I don't like this place.
What do you mean you don't feel good? Do you need a doctor?
No. It's dark in here. I'm scared.
Mom, it's night. I think you just had a bad dream. Everything will be okay in the morning. I imagine the lighthouse gets lonely, but come on. It's you who wanted to go there.
No, you don't understand. It's dark. It's awful, and I can't write. Everything is... Hello? Hello? Fuck!
Now that's no way to greet your muse. What your surprise? Creation isn't pretty. You pushed a human being into the world, and now you need to do the same with a book. I'm here to help you with that.
How?
How? She asks. The same way I helped the painter, the musician, and the actor. All you have to do is choose. Your voice will be heard.
It won't. It never is.
And now, with my help, it's possible. Do you choose to use it? Say it.
I do. I choose your help.
Then, it is done.
Hello?
Oh, thank God you're okay. What happened?
What do you mean?
You were scared, and the call was cut off, and...
Oh, that's nothing. The generator died. It's fine now.
Oh. Okay. I guess that's good. How do you feel? You sounded upset. I'm worried.
I'm good.
But...
I'm good, son. It's as you said, I'm exactly in the place I wanted to be.
Are you?
Yes, I'm sure. I need to get back to work. Good night.
Love you.
Moths, drawn to the fire between them. No matter if it the flame was desire, despair, or hate.
Blood is thick. I needed a jar and...
He tried to pull himself together.
Sweet Jesus! Did you just buy half of the department store? Honey, you don't even know yet if it's gonna be a boy or a girl.
Thank you. Let her be herself.
An idiot. To think that someone like me could ever compete with you in all your sublime beauty.
Everlasting, immortal. Even though you've not been born yet, I can already feel your presence. It's simply amazing. I just can't believe how lucky I am. A year ago, all I had was talent and ambition. Now, against all odds, I have a career, a loving husband, and you. I've never been a deeply religious person. I guess what other people look for in a sermon, I found in perfecting my art. But now, I can't help but feel like there's a higher power watching over me. They once told me that I would never succeed as a musician. Now, I'm playing sold-out concerts at some of the most prestigious venues in the country. They also said I had a difficult character and that I would never find a soulmate. Guess again. Finally, a doctor once told me that I would never be able to have children of my own. And yet, here you are, within me. I am quite possibly the happiest woman in the world. I love you so much.
As for your question, my sister tells me that Anne Blackwood is an extraordinary childminder. From what I saw, she deserves such praise.
Why would you help me?
To move most of the dolls out of her room. It was getting ridiculous. You can't just throw gifts at her whenever you feel guilty for whatever it is you feel guilty for. She needs a father, not another useless distraction.
Who are you even playing with? Time for you to choose a side.
What? What's so funny?
You see, Birdie, if you move it here and here, bam! You beat me again. Sometimes I wonder why I even bother.
What do you stand to win? Thank you. I need some peace and quiet to work. Is that too much to ask? This house is not a playground!
Your child is barely 2 years old. It's absolutely normal that she doesn't talk yet. It's not the nanny's fault, and no, stimulating your daughter's mind by reading her Nietzsche is not a good idea. For God's sake.
Like it, my little bird? Okay, we'll buy it. It will look great on the fireplace, don't you think, honey? I know she adores that toy, but I don't know. Something about it is very unsettling. Maybe it's the way she plays with it. She's not a happy child. It shows sometimes when she plays. Breaks my heart to see it. What? No. Of course cutting your hair doesn't hurt, Birdie. Brush as soft as a child's hair. Where did that come from? That's not of the toy.
Fluffy fakers, mocking me, lying still between toys. No toys allowed. Thank you.
Is this supposed to be funny?
If she really endangered your child, then yes, it is reasonable to let go of her. But maybe you should give her one more chance. Mrs. Blackwood does know how to mind children.
No. No more chances. No more risk.
Earlier today, a typical quiet and peaceful neighborhood witnessed a scene straight out of a crime drama as social services accompanied by armed police officers descended upon the residence of a once famous painter and a recent widower. Apparently, the man had broken into a children's care center downtown and absconded with one of the young patients. Our sources claimed that the girl was in fact the culprit's daughter, who had previously been removed from his care after a family court ruling. After unsuccessful attempts at negotiation, fearing that the man might harm the child, police officers stormed the building and apprehended the suspect. Eyewitnesses claimed that as the paramedics escorted the girl out of the house, the man, still in handcuffs, fell to his knees and repeatedly exclaimed, "Please, she's all I have left." A truly tragic turn.
Hmm.
Hey, what is that? Wait, what day is it?
It's Sunday? You mean well, why didn't you come and get me? God damn it! You know how I get when I'm caught up in my work!
Thank you.
Why are you doing this to me?
Near the blueberry bush by the Emerald Creek.
Oh, my children. You're both so sweet. I could eat you right up.
Be an example. Finish it!
This was a special brush, like a horsehair brush, but different. At that point, I hesitated. Will this really work? Fuck it. I was already halfway through, and besides, it's not like I can just put it all back and forget the whole thing.
Thank you.
He simply wasn't enough.
He comes to me at the bottom of the bottle. The horned master of cubism. We drink to the fall of reality. Till the shapes sharpen, and I cut myself on the rectangular, infinitely straight edges of my glass, and he retreats to his nest in the iris of my left eye.
It's hopeless. I just can't take it anymore. I might as well try to paint with both of my arms broken.
Art is beauty, writes a painter recognized widely for his talent a few years back. These painters, as they call themselves, either forgot what beauty is or decided to insult it. Waste of paint, waste of talent, waste of time.
art is not about watching. It's about feeling. With all senses, every part of your body. It's the only way to understand it. The only way to eliminate doubt.
Everything I do to stop thinking. To stop the questions. Is this really the house I know? Where am I? What is behind that door? What is behind me? The questions are worse than anything that can actually happen.
Arsonists, echoing screams. They stop at nothing. I won't go down easy.
It is no wonder that an old star rebels against the light of the sun that outshines it. Truth is, its paintings have been bland and overly conventional for many years now. They don't evoke feelings. They don't say anything important. They are, at best, pleasant to look at. Art shouldn't be pleasant. It should be world-changing.
I loved him the most when he lost himself.
Fucking mutt won't shut up!
Hey! I can do that too! See? But can you paint? No? Well, that's all right. Neither can I.
They say a picture is worth a thousand words. While this is true of many works of art, sometimes the words that come to mind are hardly flattering. Babyface is one such painting. This artistic anomaly continues to inspire thousands of mediocrity enthusiasts, when in fact, it is little more than a sideshow attraction. Frankly, this is hardly even art. It's merely a doodle. It's what you get when you lock a not very well-adjusted painter in a dark basement for a week. Even putting aside the flawed execution, the painting is still deplorable.
You left me alone.
Malcontents!
In any case, as your lawyer, I advise you to refrain from any imprudent actions. In other words, don't do anything stupid. We still have a chance of winning this. Believe it or not, I've gotten clients out of deeper shit than this. Just don't make it any worse. Lay low for a while and let me appeal the court order. This social worker definitely has it in for you. We can use that to our advantage. Portray you as a victim of the system. A husband in mourning, a momentary lapse of reason, an overzealous bureaucrat. Trust me, this is our best option. Considering what you've been through lately, I'd say we have a good 50-50 chance of a good outcome. But not if you keep trying to convince everyone that you've gone completely insane. No more outbursts, no more rambling, better yet, no public appearances whatsoever. You can still get your daughter, though.
wear me. Let me look.
What? You're sure you're safe here?
Don't believe me.
Deep breaths. Deep breaths. Remember, you're a professional. It's just the first few strokes. Then you're over the hump. What's so hard about it?
And so our agreement, although fruitful, must come to an end. We seek someone who understands modern art a little bit better, who is able to engage with it. And you, sir, don't seem to be that person anymore. Your reactions to other reviews and letters from our readers don't encourage further collaboration.
Hate it. Everyone hates it. I have to make it perfect.
That's a good question, Peter. In fact, that is a very common misconception. Some people think it's just about putting paint on canvas, but they're wrong. I believe that every detail must exist in the mind of the artist before the first stroke is made. The process itself is more about following these preconceived steps rather than just going crazy with the brush. Personally, I have always perceived it as a ritual.
A ritual? Sounds ominous.
Not necessarily, though I will admit it carries a certain risk in order to create. The artist must first deconstruct himself, figuratively speaking, of course. If the artist succeeds, what most people see as mere tools of the trade will become the implements of his ascension.
Holy artifacts.
I wouldn't go that far. Art is often quite beautiful, but the process behind it, rarely so.
I need to start practicing. I don't care what he thinks about it. I'm not myself without music.
floor creepers. Traps in the floor. Devouring my foot. Afraid to walk.
Chop!
Finish it or die trying.
Finish it if it kills you.
Don't let the doubt get you. Thank you. Art is not about watching. It's about feeling. With all senses, every part of your body. It's the only way to understand it. The only way to eliminate doubt. Thank you.
I could help him. Only I can help you.
You deserve this. All of it. All of it.
I needed something to add the, how should I put it, final touches. A finger. I needed a finger. Chopped it off. Easier than sawing a leg. Washed it, dried it in an oven, fell asleep. Almost burned it. Will I manage to pull this off?
The thought alone that the most beautiful piece of art doesn't have my name on it is killing me. So?
Been working all night.